So, on the hunt for the final dragon, Hunda, you guys made your way to Mintarn, a Port Royal Braavos type of seafaring town. There you met some of the locals, including a pair of dwarven brothers, the tyrant of the island who runs the shop, and you learned about the Blackskulls. This is a sort of town with merfolk that live there as well as humans. It's also very like Venice-like in terms of it has like loads of bridges and canals and stuff, only it's a little rough around the edges, I would say. Tristan, you arrive back in the tavern to see Marion is there. She's now all dressed up in like a swashbuckler's sort of get-up, with like a sea blue cloak and a rapier instead of her big spear. Cool. And she just like is picking up a drink from the bar, and she'll buy one for you as well. What do you want?
Be like, "Hi, Tristan. It'd be good to see ya."
Shut up. watered down ale. I was trying to think of like a what's a non-alcoholic?
Well, she will say at the bar, like, it's okay to drink alcohol as a follower of the gods, you know. She's got like an ale herself.
Yeah, I know, but it's not to do with that. It's, you know, the whole affair of coming back from the dead was rather sobering.
Fair enough. Well, just don't forget to enjoy life while you're living it.
Oh, I am enjoying my life. Look at me, I'm stress-free, honest. Rubs his brow.
She's like, can we just get a cranberry juice for this guy? Oh,
can't even get an orange juice, jeez.
Do you drink cranberry juice?
Tristan doesn't drink. You think Tristan's seen a cranberry juice before?
Well then, what do you want?
I'll have an orange juice. Oh, you know.
Right. You get given an orange juice.
I get an orange juice, yay.
Is it in a sippy cup? You're given a liquid of some sort. Just drink it.
Marion will then take you over and sit down. Say, so, what did you learn with your conversation with the tyrant?
Well, unfortunately, I let Sang do the speaking, which didn't go amazingly. But she's very... Rogar did some, you know, detect fault stuff. And she doesn't trust the group, which is understandable. And she refused to, of course, outright say anything against Hunda. There is a bounty on a kraken that's sailing round, and the others have gone to talk to the Black Sails. However, I decided to avoid that topic of conversation, considering we butchered a bunch of them earlier in last year. So
fair enough. Well, by the way, did you change your outfit, or are you still in your torn gear?
Oh, no. I changed. I'm in just chainmail.
Okay. Yeah, describe what you look like.
Tristan is just wearing like a beanie, short chainmail. He's got his sword, his shield is slung over his back, you know, and he's kind of removed any sort of torm imagery.
Yeah.
And he's just he just looks like your run of the mill warrior. Like you wouldn't be able to tell he's a paladin.
Yeah, he just sort of looks like a mercenary. I would say the shield would probably make you stand out a bit, as it is a very fancy shield. It was literally the shield of kings.
Oh yeah, but you know, you can just be like, yeah, loot it.
That's the thing, yeah. So yeah, just says I know.
You just put a cover on it.
That would look even weirder.
Yeah.
Would it?
I think so.
Yeah, because it's
be
just
like, I don't want my shield to get the paint to get scratched. I don't know.
You need to remember, Tristan was a mercenary before he was a paladin.
Yeah.
So he knows what he's doing.
But yeah, Marion will sit you down and say, well, I've been doing some thinking, and I agree with Reed. I think our priority should be getting inside Skadarak before Hunda returns. In the morning, I think some of us should scout the area and search for a way in, while the others try and pry some information out of this, either the Tyrant or the Blackskulls or some of the local who may have inside knowledge about the island or Hunda.
Well,
I think we should regroup then at sunset, and hopefully by then we'll have some sort of plan for getting into the island.
Well, I know that the entire island is rigged with traps and that he's got about 2,000 kobolds there. So he sent half of his army to attack Neverwinter, half stayed behind. We know that, and we know that the entire island is effectively a death trap because he likes to watch people struggle. So you could assume that he's got some form of magical either communication or sort of, you know, detection spells kicking around on the island.
Yes. It wouldn't surprise me if he has the ability to scry as well. I think most dragons have that ability. Well, certainly most dragons of his age.
Yes. So...
Well, ideally we need to find whatever the easiest way into this place is, and hopefully learn what resurrected him as well.
Yeah, and hopefully smash it. I did think about that. It's like the only, you know, I'm trying to think, because from what Sang said, again, it wasn't like undead. It wasn't like us bringing someone back.
Mm-hmm.
So it wasn't celestial. It wasn't necrotic.
Well, again, someone on this island must know something.
I mean, yeah, he's obviously not a lich, because, I mean... but I don't think dragons have the ability to put their soul in a phylactery.
They do. I think, but it wouldn't work exactly like he just got up and then flew away.
Exactly.
If his soul was in a phylactery, the body would have to take years to reform.
Yeah, so it's...
Well, certainly some amount of time.
Yeah, okay. Well, hopefully the others will learn something in the Black Skull's base. Provided they don't get into trouble, which they might do.
Well, let's be ready to run to their aid if we. Yes. She'll just then raise her ale.
Possibly go wrong.
And say cheers.
Cheers.
But Tristan, you could come with us. You could put the bat cape on.
It's too late.
It is too late. Going back to the other four of you, what are you guys all dressing? Like, what's your current get up look like?
Just like disguise I normally kit. Do, just with... I will be wearing my mask, though, out in public. Looking all mercenary, I already look like.
Mm-hmm. Daylight, you just look like yourself?
I mean, sort of. Like, I think I said last time I took off the goggles. Like,
Yeah.
I just wore, like, a normal, like, brown cloak, I'll say.
And, Reed?
And I'll also put a bow on my back. To make it look like I'm an archer.
Cool.
Yeah, I'm in like a sort of kind of like strider, like a
ranger's garb, sort of.
Yeah, like a poncho kind of thing, but like a black one, poncho.
But as you guys are walking, Rogar, who just sort of likes normal Rogar, he's with you guys at the moment. Yeah. He will turn to you and say, "Other news we're thinking, guys, and." I'm gonna stick around until this dragon's dealt with, because he seems like way harder than the rest, so you might need me.
Yeah, I think it might be useful to get a destination with figure out where Tristan's gonna be. So if you need to teleport, you can teleport. If shit hits the fan, you can teleport to Tristan and then pick him up and bring him back.
What, like tonight?
Well, whenever, if we're on the island and we get caught. Tristan might be useful in a fight.
Yeah,
we've rested though since we came here, so.
Yeah, well, it's nighttime now, and so Rogar will say, "Well, I think he's going back to the tavern. Merrin will be there, so like if we do run into trouble, I can always teleport back to the tavern and hopefully meet them there."
But didn't Rogar use his teleports to get us here?
Oh shit! Yeah, I did. Yeah, I've got no teleports for today.
To be fair, Rogar, that's totally. Method acting right there.
Yeah.
You'll be alright tomorrow, Rogar.
So, yeah, I'll be fine. See them tomorrow or still now?
We'll still go now. What could have been wrong?
Yeah. We're not like.
We're just gonna talk to them.
Yeah.
No, are we?
Yeah.
I think that's the plan.
What did you think we were doing?
Oh, sorry. Yeah. I'm getting muddled up.
We're not going to the island.
Who should do the talking? I think it should be Reed, but I don't know. Sang Dela, you're like unscrupulous folk. Maybe they'll like talk better with you. I don't know.
What does that mean?
As long as it's not you, Rogar, I think we'll be all right.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying, basically.
Reed's pretty persuasive.
Yeah, we'll let Reed.
What am I? What are we trying to persuade them to? Just get as much information as possible.
Yeah, so our cover story is that we're like a band of mercenary bounty hunters.
Yeah.
And we're new in port. And obviously we're like looking for high value stuff. Contracts.
Yeah.
What's our name?
I forgot. Reed came up with the name, but I forgot what it... No, Tristan came up with the name, I think.
Did he?
Well, the Black Skulls don't know anyway, so we can just make up a new one.
Someone came up with a name, but I forgot what it was. Did you remember what it was?
Did I write it down?
It was something very complicated.
I sure didn't.
It was a... Vicroyan Mex Lestorial.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yes. Yes, it was something like that, yeah.
Cool.
But yeah, yeah, basically we want to like try and hint at the dragon and then see what she says, but without like directly saying anything. I feel like...
What,
she...
trying to get more info?
Yeah, because this person might be a bit more like agreeable to talk about the dragon than the tyrant, because the tyrant is like, oh, but otherwise the city will get burned down and all that if the dragon gets angry. Whereas a pirate isn't really going to care about that, so...
Okay. Alright, let's go speak to her.
I'll say, yeah, at this point, you reach the harbour area, and you do see a ship with Black Skull sails.
Do you want names, guys?
No. In fact, yeah, go on then.
What's Umberly?
Umberly is the goddess that one of the Black Skulls here, you know, is a like fanatic of that particular goddess. Umberly being one of the gods of the sea, basically.
Okay.
They're evil gods.
She's chaotic AF.
Yeah.
Can you give us all names, please?
Yeah. You're going to be... Dela's going to be Umbra. You're going to be Tartholomew. And I'm going to be Steve.
Can I be Rogar?
You can be Togar.
Togar, sick.
Togar.
yeah, so, you walk up to this this Black Skull ship. You see it's called Tempest, and it is fully outfitted with cannons. How do you approach the ship? You see, like, there's like a good amount of the crew at the moment are like chilling on deck. You imagine another
steal this ship now.
You know, a good amount of the crew would probably be on the island as well. But there's still a decent amount of people.
We walk on all confident, like, being like, we would like to speak with your captain whilst inspecting the cannons and shit.
Well, as you like approach the gangplank to walk on, someone will stop you on the other side and be like, okay, who the fuck are you?
Oh, sorry, just getting past.
They're not going to let you pass.
Yeah, I'm gonna trying to get past. I'm just saying it.
Okay, they're going to say, who are you?
We're a mercenary company, and we're looking for some work. So we would like to speak to your captain.
One moment. He will go away, but then like there's a few other people just watching, making sure you don't
Can I tip my hat to them, or my hood to them?
Yes, you can. They seem to be drinking rum at the moment, and they just give you a nod back. A man will then approach. You see, he's like missing an eye, and in place of his eye, the first thing you notice is like he's got this almost like a big glowing ice shard instead of an eye. He looks in his like 50s or 60s, pretty old, like a massive grey beard, grey hair. Just say, so, you want to join my crew?
Not quite. We're looking for any particular work you may have. We're a mercenary company, and we only deal with high targets because we're highly skilled. What's your name, sir?
My name is Shiver.
And your surname?
I just go by Shiver.
Can I suggest a surname?
Roll a persuasion check. Sure.
Me? Timbers.
I thought you might have said that. I've heard it before.
What about...
I don't care for jokers. Not on my ship. And if you're looking for work, you're looking for work on my ship. We don't give out work. We take the work. If you want to work with us, prove yourself.
Well, how would we, as you put it, prove ourselves? What would you have in store?
Well, maybe what exactly can you bring to a ship? What are your what skills? And we would test you on whatever those skills might be.
I can sing, dance, and add charm to any adventure. This guy over here, his name is Umbra, and he can do all kinds of tricks, all kinds of maneuvers, all kinds of skills. And yeah, he can throw knives really well.
So a fighter.
Yeah. And then we got this other guy over here. She's called Tartholomew. And she's like really fast. Like she can run like really fast, you know?
Well, running really fast isn't really a skill that's needed on a ship. You can only really run so far from one end to the other.
Well, if you're trying to rock the boat, it comes in handy. Am I right?
I've never had to rock the boat for any particular reason before. The waves seem to do that just fine.
Okay, and we got Toga over here, and he's really smart.
Yeah, like ask me any question.
And he knows the answer. So
What's that person's name? We're just like, Clive? It's like, yeah, he's right. My name is Clive.
See? There you go. That's Toga. Smart, intelligent, courageous. That's yeah. him. Toga. Now anyway, what would you have us do? We would like high value target, preferably a Kraken.
Not a Kraken.
We want to kill a Kraken. How would we go about doing that? On your ship.
So you want to commandeer my ship in order to go and hunt this Kraken? Commandeer.
Why don't you? I think you're a skilled captain, correct?
I am a skilled captain, and I will suffer no shenanigans on my ship.
Very well. Well, we're interested in a Kraken, but it's not our main goal. We're here for work. What work can we do for you?
Well, like I say, we take the jobs ourselves. You would have to join our crew, and you'd get a cut of whatever jobs we undertake. The pay won't be very good to begin with, as you're only new recruits, but if you can prove yourselves useful, we could potentially up your earnings in a year or two.
Okay, I'm going to turn to the boys, say, one moment, I'm going to huddle us all together. Like, guys,
on the gangplank.
off the gangplank on the other side.
Well, I kind of want to do it on the gangplank now.
I mean, they can absolutely hear you then, but sure.
So guys, what do you want to do? I mean, this isn't really what we had
in mind. This guy isn't the boss. The boss is a crazy woman.
You're right.
You should ask him who he gets his jobs from. And then if his only job is for us to join the crew, then we should go straight to his boss. And then we can ask her where she is.
That sounds like a good plan. Are we all in agree, Togar and Umbra?
Yeah. Let's do that.
By the way, what was your name? Reed, what's your name?
Steve.
Okay.
Oh man, it's the easiest one. I didn't even introduce myself.
Nope.
Anyway, I'm going to go back to him. I'll say, tell me, Shivers, who's your boss?
Why do you think I have one?
I'm just curious, that's all.
Well, I'm my own boss.
Everybody, let's... Between me and you, everybody answers to someone, am I right?
Go ahead and roll persuasion with disadvantage. Well, I assume you know of the Blackskulls, so I do have a boss, if you must know. But their business is mine.
Where would I... We really are interested in mercenary work, as opposed to being joining a crew.
Then the mercenary board is that way. It'll point up towards the castle.
I wish to speak to your superior. I'd like to speak to the manager.
No. We don't know you. And quite frankly, I don't trust you.
Why not?
It seems odd that you would just happen upon our ship and start asking questions looking for my boss.
We, as I've said before, we are only interested in high-value targets. We've recently joined...
Like I've told you, we don't give out work. We're not in that business. We take work.
But your boss might be able to, so I need to speak to that person ASAP. And just imagine if your boss was to have a high target and you've turned us away, I don't think they'd be happy with your decision.
If my boss had a high value target, I'd do the work that needs to be done. We don't need the likes of you.
You don't need mercenaries?
No.
Well, I can sing and dance.
Then play us a song.
Very well. And if, well, what do I get if I play the song well?
Some of the lads might feel generous and give you a coin or two.
If I get your guys, if I entertain your guys with a song and a dance successfully, I think you should grant us some time with your boss.
You see, the very insistence on you meeting my boss, specifically when you have no other ulterior motive, means that you do have an ulterior motive, and for that reason, I'm going to have to ask you to leave.
No, of course we have an ulterior motive, but it's something we'll only discuss with your boss.
You can discuss it with me.
No, we can't.
Well, you can, because I'm standing right here.
Listen, I think we should just find his boss. He's clearly taking the piss, and like, you're wasting not only your own time, but our time.
What is your business with my boss?
How about we say we have a proposition for your boss?
What might this proposition be?
Something that could involve a lot of gold for us and your organization.
I am listening. Do go on.
Well, the details we will only discuss with your boss.
I'm afraid I won't allow that. You'll have to talk to me.
Let's go and discuss.
Okay, everyone on the ship now is now on high alert. Everyone's got weapons at the ready.
Group huddle.
You guys are sus as hell.
Well, of course
I don't think it's working.
I think
guys.
We should just walk away at this point. Like, he's yeah. not playing ball. He's just
no shit.
Why don't we just kill them and take their shit?
To be fair, we could.
How many of them are there, Patrick?
Let me check. I mean, there's still like people wandering about the docks as well, and just because like they'll probably get involved as well. This isn't a completely lawless town. You can't just go around murdering people.
Just kick the plank, though. Could just kick the plank though.
It's true.
Or we could just walk away. Like these guys, we could just follow him late at night.
Make a perception check for me to read the ship. 13. They probably have like around 30 people there.
Oh, we can take.
Have they drawn their swords?
They've got like swords at the ready.
Yeah.
They're not quite drawn, but they are ready to be drawn if they're expecting you to do something. Cause...
Or, like you said, we could like pretend to leave, but then as we're leaving, Reed, you turn someone invisible and then they like double back and like see, because now we've gone asking for their boss, they're going to have to report this to their boss. They're going to be like, yo, someone's out looking for you. Like,
true. Yeah, let's just walk away from this. You're like, listen, mate, we're not interested. We want to speak with your boss either way. So you can do this the easy way or the hard way. We will have a conversation at some point. So you're just making this a lot harder than it needs to be. But we're going to leave now because you're just wasting everybody's time.
Good to know. I'll be seeing you soon.
All right, let's go.
Leave?
I think so.
Yeah.
Let's not kill those people. If they had drawn swords first, I think we were actually entitled to fight them, but they didn't, so...
So are we going to do what I suggested and, like, turn someone invisible?
Dela, can I turn you invis?
Yeah, okay. She's probably on the ship, though, isn't she?
Well, yeah, not on the ship.
No, well, not necessarily, because if he's the captain, they can't have, like, two captains on one ship. She's probably got her own ship, or she's somewhere else on the island. But either way,
let's
it's
just
worth
follow them. I can turn us all invisible if we want.
That would be too suspicious, because they might
person,
be follow us as
like,
well.
Did the tyrant say that this ship was where the person was?
No, he didn't say She didn't know where they were exactly. Oh. She just said you could find them down in the docks, but she didn't know where the leader would be.
Yeah. I think we'll just... Once we leave, can we run around a few corners? I'll cast Pass Without a Trace, and then we'll hide on some rooftop and scout and watch them.
Are you going to turn us all invisible? Because we need to pass be close that. Enough to be able to follow them.
That's not if they
We need to first establish who's leaving the ship and when they are. There's no point in turning invisible immediately, because they might not alert the captain straight away.
Okay.
So I'll do Pass Without a Trace, and then whoever, when we spot someone leaving, we'll do invis. Yeah, right, so we'll go on to some rooftop and watch them for a while and see if anyone comes off or on.
Brogar's gonna say, well, I'm pretty useless at this, so like, I'm gonna head back. But yeah, see you guys later.
Bye, Brogar.
Okay.
The rest of you roll.
Whilst we're on the roof, can I say to the guys, yeah, that didn't really go well, did it?
roll me just stealth checks.
That guy was just...
Oh, wow.
Nat 30, 1, 26. A 36 from Daylar's Nat 1.
Nice.
But a Nat 1 is still a Nat 1.
That kicks a tile off the roof.
Absolutely does.
Falls on someone's head.
No, it doesn't.
it kills the messenger.
Yeah, we'll say you guys are watching the ship from a bit of a distance. Yeah.
Anything happen?
How long do you want to stay there?
It's
like 9 o'clock at night at the moment.
We'll stay till 11, right?
At least, yeah.
Okay. Watch until 11. They seem to be on high alert for about 30, 45 minutes before like calming down a little bit. They're still on alert. They're just chilling on the ship. Yeah, not particularly going anywhere. You gather these guys are on like guard duty, to, you know, guard the ship.
Can I say to the others, should we wait another hour? If nothing happens, let's just go onto the ship, go into the captain's quarters, and just
sneak
question
into
him.
The ship. Yes,
yeah,
like...
just like we'll proper intimidate him.
Yeah,
or I can modify his memory or whatever. I can just we'll
chop
just get
his hands off.
Yeah, just fucking murder the
maybe
shit
not
out.
Quite that, but yeah.
Okay, well, maybe not that, yeah. Nah, yeah.
Yeah, I like this idea, yeah.
All right. Yeah, let's wait another hour.
You wait another hour, then I guess you're turning everyone invisible?
Yeah, that'll be level 4, right?
Yes.
All right, I can fly, so I'll just fly over there.
Okay, what are the other two of you doing?
Well, I can't fly, so I'm just going to have to stealth
my
way.
Okay.
I do have flying potions, I think, if you want them.
I mean, it seems a bit of a waste to use it right now.
Yeah, no worries.
Yeah, we'll see what we can do without it, I think.
Can I get stealth checks from Dela and Sang? These are made just straight rolls, not advantage.
Oh, no, Reed, you should be staying with us because we get past without trolls.
I think that's I think that's
end. Yeah, true. Yeah.
But yeah, 23 and 30.
So it's advantage.
It's not actually, because the boards here are very creaky. Yeah, no, they literally are.
I know, it's just funny. That's the reason. Creaky boards.
Yeah. Either way, 23 and 35 is solid. Bearing in mind, you're all invisible. Reed, what are you doing?
I'm just going to head in then. Hovering off the
floor. I assume we would have agreed beforehand what we were going to do there.
And yet you didn't, so no.
Well, we're heading down to the captain's quarters, so whichever way seems the most easiest to get down there, whether it's through the opening.
Actually, to be fair, that was what we said we were going to do, we were going to intimidate the captain.
yeah, you did say that, but like you didn't say how exactly you were going to get there. Or you don't know where the captain's quarters are.
Yeah, so we're going to go below deck to try and find them, or at the very least, back of the ship.
Yeah.
So if there's a window open...
Is this ship the same like design as the one that we stole from them?
Yes.
Oh, then we know exactly where the captain's quarters is.
Not necessarily.
Well, we'll head to where we think it is, essentially.
Mm-hmm.
So at the back, at the sort of back of the ship. Are there any windows... Can I inspect to see if there's any windows open or unlocked windows?
Yeah, I think you'd probably be able to squeeze through like a cannon hole, Reed. The other two of you will just sneak down on your own. Either way, all three of you will come to the door of the captain's quarters. It is locked.
Can we listen to see if we can hear anybody in there?
Or talking or anything like that? Yeah, make a perception check. You don't hear anyone in there, but the door's locked.
Okay. Me and Dela try and pick the lock.
Well, it'd be easier if one of you do it, but...
Does that drop invisibility?
No, it doesn't.
Okay.
Daylight, you should...
I think Daylight's the best at it.
Check it for traps as well while you're doing it.
Mm. Yeah, of course.
Investigation first, then, for searching for traps. Not trapped?
Thieves' tools, right?
Thieves,
yeah. Oh wait, it's asking me for an attribute. Do I just put dexterity?
Oh shit, yeah. Yeah, you just put dexterity.
Ooh, that's
cool.
And it's stealthily as well.
Of course. Yeah, roll stealth.
Okay.
You would not have advantage on this one, but that's fine.
Voice.
Yeah, you do open the door pretty easily. Peeking on inside, you can see there's a single candle that has been left lit. On a desk, and the captain himself is just lying in bed. It's midnight at this point, so.
Should we search the drawers first to see who he's communicating with? Or should we just go straight for him? Should we blindfold him?
Lock the door back first. Yeah. Can we gag him as well?
Yeah, gag him and tie him up.
Yeah,
should we have this conversation outside of the room?
Yeah.
Yeah, we'll gag him and. And then time up like straight away. But Dela, you lock the door behind us.
Okay. Do you need to roll for that?
No. That's fine. Alright. So yeah, do your plan as you want to do it.
So we're gonna go. I'll go for his blindfolding first. Can someone gag and someone restrain?
I'll gag it.
I have minus one strength, so.
Oh, do you? None of us are very strong. But I'll restrain
you
him then.
You have minus one strength.
I
that's
don't...
weaker than me.
I have zero, so.
Yeah, I'm zeros too.
I'll restrain him then.
Right.
Okay, you gag it.
Okay.
Okay. Three.
Hold on. All of you make stealth checks for me again, please. Sang, you did not quite roll high enough.
Uh-oh.
And he spins around and shoots you, so.
What?
Before I react.
In his bed.
He's got aimbot.
Yeah.
Hang on. Before I react, do we not get any chance to respond?
No. He was awake and ready with a pistol. Either way, the shot missed.
Who was he shooting at?
You.
Oh, yeah, that easily missed.
Well, you're all invisible, but he shot at the sound of you.
Okay.
The sound has made noise.
Restraint, lock the doors.
Doors are already locked. Doors already locked.
Barred it.
I'll say, can I get strength checks from all three of you?
Oh, yeah. Just straight strength, right?
Yeah.
He
just pushes you all off him.
Are you all in viz as well?
Yeah, and now you're all in viz.
Right, modify memory. Cast modify memory.
I was going to say roll initiative.
Yeah, that makes sense at this point.
Ooh, am I going to get higher than you bitches?
We're the worst.
Oh. It never goes to plan, though. One eye shiver. Fuck you, dude.
Dela, you're first.
Am I in like melee range or what?
Yeah, because you've all like tried to jump on him, so would all be like pretty close to him now.
Okay, I'll just like can I like jump at him and like try and cover his mouth?
Yeah, sure.
He's already made a gunshot, so
yeah.
Actually, I'll do that anyway. I'll do it anyway, just so we can't.
Sure. I'll say yeah. Just make an opposed athletics check for me, please.
What the hell? D&D is broken, man.
a breeze hits you and you fall over.
Oh my god, I've never seen that before in my life.
That's funny. Just because of that, I'm going to say you fall and hit your head and take 2 points of damage. Two nat zeros.
That was a strong gust of breeze through his cabin window.
Yeah, that just knocks you over. Sang, you're up.
Oh my lord.
Oh my god, what happened?
Nothing.
I went to get some brownies and I've come back to your fighting.
Yeah.
Look at Daylar's double zero.
Holy shit, Daylar.
I'm going to shout to... Well, I guess it actually will be too late. I'm just going to use Hour of Reaping to terrify him.
Oh my god.
He must make a wisdom saving throw, but so did Daylar and Reed.
Okay.
He fails.
Fuck.
You fail.
Okay, so you are frightened?
Yes. Reed, you're frightened of me.
Actually, yeah, you know what? The advantage would be a nat 1 for you, so go ahead and roll again. Whatever the next roll is, we'll count. 12 still fails.
Fuck.
So yeah, you're frightened for one turn.
Offsang.
Yes. Yeah, but so is he. Reed, it is your turn.
I'm going to modify
him. I wanted to say something to him as well.
Oh, sorry.
Okay, sure.
I'd say, we're not here to kill you, but if you keep resisting, we will.
Okay, go ahead and roll Intimidation for me, with advantage, because of Hour of Reaping. Lol.
With disadvantage, because you saw me knock myself out.
Our rolls are so bad.
I mean, it would still be with advantage, because of the magical effect, but yeah, a 5 is not going to cut it. But yeah, now it is your turn.
Okay, I'm going to modify his memory.
What's the range on modify memory?
30 feet.
Cool. So you do have to run all the way to the end of the room, away from Sang, but you can do it from there. And what do you... well, he has to make a save, right? He fails, so yeah.
That's a lot of text.
That is a lot of text. Still good, still good to have.
He has advantage because he's resisting.
I mean, that's still, yes, still a fail. So yeah, what do you modify his memory
I'm going to say, we are his friends, and he talks openly with us because of our good relationship, and he's willing to tell us everything about his boss, and where to find it.
Okay.
And he's not alarmed by us being in his room late at night, because that's what we were doing beforehand. We're his friends. That's what we do. That's what we do. We hang out in his room at night.
Just kissing the homies goodnight.
Okay. At the end of this, there will be someone furiously trying to get into the room. Chibble will then say, hold on, guys. So it's all right. And he will unlock the door, open it up.
All
the guys on the other side. You can if you want.
Yeah, behind the door.
Shiver's going to say, it was all right, lads. Those guys from earlier are just in here. They were but don't worry, they've explained themselves. They caught me off guard. They gave me a fright, but everything's fine now. No, the guys are just like, all right. And they were like, very cautiously walk away, but still very much on guard.
Why did he have to say that? And can I tell him that? Why did you have to say that it was the guys from earlier? Tell them it was someone else.
But you're my friends, why would I lie?
Still, like, not everyone should know that we're in your room late at night on a weekend.
I've got no problem with letting people know.
Okay, fine then, Shivers.
It's just Shiver.
You give me shivers with your fucking... I don't know. Your eye. Sorry. I know friends should do that. Friends are better than that.
Yeah, anyway, I believe
that was helpful. That was very helpful.
You were telling us about your boss before we were interrupted?
Yeah, remember. Your boss.
Hey, yes. The Wavemistress. I can take you to see her tomorrow, if you want.
Okay. Can you not just take us now?
Do you ask that? Do you say that to him?
Yeah. Can you not just take us now?
Well, no, half the crew are still on the island, and, it's the middle of the night.
Still.
Where is she, by the way? Is it, like, far away, just so we know if we need to be prepared?
She's in like a hidden cove here on the island, but it's far enough that it would best go in the morning.
Very well.
Okay.
So right. Shall we meet you on your ship here then?
Hey, sounds good.
What time?
8 o'clock.
Earlier.
7:59. Sounds good. Cool. So, I just noticed that. So it says you can, like, use Modify Memory to change an event in the past 24 hours, but it doesn't say, like, how long the Modify Memory lasts. So it just say it can be removed by, like...
Could it be permanent?
But, like, I just Googled it, like, and it says it's permanent without magical intervention.
Yeah.
Oh, there we go, then. Yeah.
Interesting.
So we don't need to worry about the time.
In the Modify Memory, can I, like, have a whole backstory of how we met?
No, you would.
It would all be in there.
Yeah, because I don't want to like go to meet this woman and she's like, well, you've charmed my captain. And it's like, well, yeah.
Well, you guys meeting wouldn't be modified. But you're... Yeah. No. Well, yeah, it says you can change an encounter that lasted no more than 10 minutes. So you can only change stuff within that 10 minutes. So essentially, you sneaking
into
this
room... How we met all earlier is the same.
That would be the same.
Okay. Then he thinks that we're good friends now after we met him in his room.
He thinks you guys snuck into his room and then convinced him that you were his friends and then he was all good.
Alright. Nice. I love it when that happens.
A normal event.
Because Modify Memory.
Yes.
Well.
Alright then, let's go in the morning. I can't wait to explain this to Tristan.
Well, Tristan and Mary and I assume would be asleep at this time.
Yes.
So you'll have to tell him in the morning. But
now we'll go to his room at midnight and we're going to tell him.
Or you do that.
Nah. So, right. Can we bring the captain to Tristan's room?
Yeah, we've got another friend who really wants to meet you.
Yeah, now we'll just go. I think, should we just head back, boys?
Yeah, yeah. Good night, Mr. Captain Shivers.
Good night. Yeah, you guys head back to the tavern. I can't remember if you got rooms each. I think you might have.
Marion was sorting it out, wasn't she?
Yeah, we'll say she's paid for you each to have a room for the night.
Very generous of her.
I know. Shout out to Marion.
Yeah.
Then we've got to wake up early to meet Mr. Shivers.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So the three of you wake up nice and early.
Is Tristan awake?
No. Well, what time is it?
Like, six, half six?
Then no.
No.
Guys, right, shall we go and...
Does Roger want to go?
Wake Tristan up. Oh, yeah,
and Roger and Marion all asleep because it's 6:30 in the morning.
I want to...
We can't just wake him up, though.
Right. Yeah. Oh, yeah, you absolutely can.
Knock on Tristan's door.
Yeah.
I will roll a constitution save to see if
can we wake him up at 7? I want a lion.
Patrick, do I wake up or not?
We need to get there.
Yes, you can wake everybody up.
And then we explain what happened last night.
I'm just going to sigh. Like...
Go on then.
Miriam will say, what's the purpose of this? Why are we looking for this woman?
This pirate lady might be more willing to help us in some way to defeat a dragon than or she might have more information about it that she'd be willing to share than the tyrant. Because the tyrant's worried about the city being harmed by people going after the dragon, but this pirate lady probably won't really care about that.
But why would a pirate lady have any knowledge about this?
Because they've sailed around these waters all the time.
Well, that doesn't
mean they would. The dragon has a lot of gold, so maybe they've been trying to find ways to get in there themselves. Pirates love gold.
Pirates do love gold, but not they don't love dying. Pretty much anyone who goes after this dragon dies.
That's why they've not gone after it yet.
This lady is an evil priestess, though.
Exactly. Further improves our chances.
No, it doesn't.
Yeah, because she's more likely to be crazy.
I think we should just go to the island, just ditch our friend.
Well, no, I'm not outright saying this is a bad idea. I do think we need more information, and this is a possible lead. I don't think all of us should go, though. I think some of us should scout out the island, try and look for a different way in. The dragon could be back any day now, and we need to get into here quick. I don't want to put all our eggs in one basket and hope that this random woman might know, might have answers. We need to be looking in other places as well.
Perhaps the pirates could even ally with us to try and...
Oh, allying if we with promise, pirates is not a good idea.
If we promise them a share of the gold...
No, we can't do that. Though.
Honestly, I think a full-on attack isn't going to work anyway. If we're trying to be going in there sneakily and stealthily, they'll just be making too much noise. The smaller the group, the better.
It's not that they go in with us. They create a distraction for us to go
in. I don't think we should I don't think we should make any promises or alliances with a pirate group. Considering
we noticed their ship had cannons on it.
We already owe...
That could be a very big distraction.
It could be.
But you want to split, like... No.
I mean, no, after we get the gold, we can just go and kill the pirates and take their ship.
The pirates.
After we've fought
then
a dragon.
Then we have more cannons for our own ship.
All we need to do is to ask them to, like, pay them, essentially. Promise them a share of the gold to essentially distract the soldiers for 1 hour. And then tell them
just to, give
to
us
sail off
to get it.
Before the dragon arrives. And we can meet them, I don't know, at Candle's Keep in a few days' time.
You want pirates
just
to sail into Candle Cape?
Well, it may be in the secret cove where this pirate lady is.
Yeah, hide in the cove.
Or wherever they want to meet.
Any interaction with this group of pirates just seems awful. Like, we've had interactions with this group before, and it didn't go well for anybody.
It didn't go well for them. It went well
for us.
It went pretty well for you guys, actually.
Beforehand, you weren't cutting a deal with them.
No, but we don't want to cut a deal with them. They shouldn't be, like, we shouldn't be bartering with the idea of pirate group.
But it's for the greater good, because we'll liberate the island from a dragon,
exactly.
and then
hopefully liberate them from pirates as well, because we'll just steal the ship.
Yeah, we don't actually have to give them the gold. Or we can give
them
the gold. Or, if you want to be honest, we can give them the gold, and then we can just take it back by killing them.
Yeah. Well, not... you could just take it back, but...
Marion will speak and will say, I don't think we should work with these people. However, I do think someone should go to see what they can learn. I think pirates will probably double cross us, and sure, we might be able to kill them all, but really, I don't care about them. They're not our priority. The dragon is.
I mean, all we need from them is to be a distraction. If they double cross us, what are we going to do? Like,
I don't know. I just think we're wasting too much time dealing with these pirates when the dragon is our concern. He could be back any day now. We need to be getting into that volcano as soon as possible.
So that's fine, so we split up, they could give us a lift there, couldn't they?
No, we need to stop thinking about getting these pirates involved, because dragging another party into this is just gonna cause more chaos and it's not, though. We're perfectly capable as a group of just infiltrating. We've done
not
it before.
In a dragon's lair.
Well, I've said that from the get-go. I've said that I think we should have
to deal with intruders.
But go, that's the thing, we need to go there now and see what we're up against. From the sounds of things, what Tristan told me last night, that doesn't sound like we're getting in through the front door. But it's still worth scouting out our options.
Yeah, so who wants to do that then? If we want to split up?
Well, do any of you have the ability to turn invisible or change your form or anything like that?
Reed, you can turn yourself into a kobold.
A kobold wouldn't be good. A seagull would be perfect.
Yeah, okay, so just polymorph essentially onto the island and have a look around.
Yeah, fly, just fly around, just scout it out, see what we're up against. As like I say, there's a lot of seagulls around here. That particular bird would probably blend in quite nicely.
Then me and Daylar should meet the pirates. Anyway, it has to be me and Daylar that go, because that bloke only knows us and he's only friends.
He knows Rogar as well.
No, Rogar wasn't there when he agreed that we were his friends. Remember the whole modified memory thing?
Yeah, but like, I thought he'd be friends with all of us now.
Oh.
No, he'd only be friends with the ones that were there.
That might be a bit too risky.
Okay.
Yeah.
Right.
I don't know. I will go, but like, maybe I should go.
Yeah. If you guys need to get out,
exactly.
Have Rogar with you.
I'll be able to like teleport you out.
Yeah, I suppose. What do you think, Damon?
I mean, I think we should first think about like what exactly we're going to ask her.
Well, how about we propose going after the dragon to see what she says?
Oh my god.
I don't think we mention the dragon personally.
For
all we know, they could be allied with the dragon.
Yeah, she's an evil storm priestess. She probably is.
We don't know that, but my point is exactly we don't
know. Then how else are we going to try and get information about the island without mentioning anything about the dragon?
Guys, if you really want, I can modify his memory again to tell him that we're going after the dragon.
No, like, I've struck up a bit of a rapport with the dwarves working the forge here. I'll go and talk to them, get some information, see if they know anyone else.
Okay, well, you do that. Me and Dale will go and meet this guy. We can discuss what we're going to say on the way.
Just don't bring the rest of us.
I just have a bad feeling about it.
So do I. Just, it's not... It just seems like such a... Like, we don't need it.
You don't know that yet.
Well, just don't mention the dragon. Don't mention any form of attack.
We're not going to get information about the island without mentioning anything about the dragon.
Yeah, well, the thing is, if you think about it, if we give this Storm Priestess, what if she is allied with Hundar?
Well, maybe we don't need to say that we're going after the dragon.
What about this tyrant lady? If you have the ability to modify people's memories, why not modify her memory? She seems like the one who knows things.
She was surrounded by mages and magic people.
I feel like dabbling in the memories of a ruler is not particularly the best way forward. Because there's always the chance it can fail as well.
Very well. Leave it up to your decision.
I still feel we have to show our faces now with the pirate people, because we've already broke into that guy's ship and convinced him we're his friends. So it'll be a bit suspicious if we don't turn up.
But you're all disguised, right?
Of course.
Well, then it doesn't matter.
Well, yeah, but other people would have seen us around.
Can I just fly around the island and then, like, try and link up with these guys with the ship whilst they're sailing to the cove?
You could certainly try. It's probably quite a distance from where you currently are to the island, and you'd have to make that distance back.
Is the island on the map?
No. Hmm. I'll show you it on the main map real quick. Zoom in on Mintarn.
Okay. Yeah, it's actually quite far.
So yeah, it's like 50 miles away.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay.
It's a ways.
Yeah.
But I'll still scope it out. Yeah. I could just go with you guys, and then I scope it out. Do you want to do that?
In the evening.
That will waste a lot of time, yeah, and it'll get dark.
Okay. Yeah. All right, then I'll just scope it out. I'll fly off.
Yes. Or if somebody else has the ability to transform themselves.
True. Someone does, don't they?
I don't know.
Didn't we have some polymorph thing?
There was a wand, but...
A wand of polymorph. Can we give that to...
Attunement.
A...
No.
An hour. It takes an hour. Yeah, Rogar will say, I could attune to it and just scout the island then.
Yeah. It means you... Teleporting, though.
Yeah, it means you won't have me for teleport.
Oh, actually, but if Rogar does go polymorph and get close to the island, it means that if we do want to teleport onto the island, he'll have that location.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Point.
Yeah,
and he already knows the ship, so could he technically teleport onto the ship after his polymorph is done?
You can't teleport onto the ship. Like, he would teleport to where the ship was, but not the... Like, you can't teleport to a moving place. You just teleport to where that place was last seen, sort of thing.
I see.
Yeah, so... that's fine then. So, Reed, you come with us, and Rogar...
I'll do some scouting.
I'm sure we'll be fine.
And Marion will say, and I'll go with you, Tristan, to speak with these dwarves.
Yeah.
Okay.
I wonder, like, if there's, like, someone on this island who's, like, really old and they've been here their entire lives. I wonder if there's, like, someone like that who might know...
Probably.
Like, more about the dragon.
I would imagine so. We could look into that, Tristan, while the others are away.
Yeah. We should. Okay. Get some. At least two of us can get some information without being killed by pirates.
Well, I don't think your friends here will be killed by pirates. They may just cause more trouble than it's worth. But anyway, good luck to you.
We love a bit of trouble.
So yeah, the three of you will then set off to the docks. Yeah, what do you do as you approach the ship?
All right, so what's our plan to talk to the woman? They say don't mention the dragon, but how are we going to get information without mentioning the dragon?
I mean, we could just modify her memory as well.
If she is like this cultist crazy lady, she might have some kind of high resistance to mind influence.
Yeah.
Then she'll be like, well, what did you try to do to me? And then we'll be like, bye, and we'll have to run.
But we can't buy because Rogar's not here.
Exactly, yeah.
Just skedaddle.
So I think we have to just speak to her normally. Because she's likely to be surrounded by a lot of crew members as well.
Yes.
I mean, we did kind of say that we had a proposition for her to the captain.
Our proposition could be to, I don't know, a share of the dragon's
thingy. But they said don't mention the dragon.
Who said that?
That's what
Tristan.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, we could just ignore what Tristan said.
We could use that Kraken, like, bounty, like, and say, oh, well, we can work together on it, like.
But then that tells us nothing about the dragon's island.
I think we have to be
upfront
and just say what we're doing with the dragon.
If we need to talk about proposition, then we can say that.
I think, why don't we say, we've recently arrived, but we've heard that the dragon is not at home. Yeah. Yes. And
we want
thinking,
to steal,
do they...
we could pose as thieves,
yes.
Maybe.
Yeah, we're like, we're a mercenary company, and we're thinking we could sneak our way in.
Burglars.
Yeah, and would she be interested in helping us at all, or providing any information for a share? Yeah.
We just need a distraction, maybe, and information.
Well, we'll see what she says first of all. Because we don't even have to agree to anything, like, immediately. We could then say, oh, okay, we're going to have to discuss with the rest of our group.
Yeah, we'll go sort all the details.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, meet at this time and then, yeah. Okay.
Exactly, yeah.
All right,
unless
let's
get that far.
Yeah.
So what do you say as you approach the ship? Tempest.
We'll ask for our friend.
And Shiver.
Jack. Shiver.
Shiver. Well, meet you aboard. Say, there you are, lad and lady. Ready to go?
Yes.
Yep.
Ready to go.
Then let's set sail. And you spend the sort of next couple hours just sailing around the island. We'll say in that time, Tristan. What did you want to be doing?
We're going to go walk to the Dwarven Forge.
Okay, well, the forge is... the shop in town or the actual forge itself, which is up in the mountain?
We'll see if they're in their shop. Because there's no point in walking up to the town, if the forge, if they're not there.
you see their shop in town. It's called Ironstar Weapons and Armor.
Okay, we'll enter.
Mm-hmm.
Are they there?
The dwarves are not. There's just a guy behind the desk. So, can I help you guys?
Is he dwarven or human?
Human.
Ah, I'll just be like, ah, hello. I'm just looking for the proprietors of this place.
Oh, they're the dwarves.
Yes.
Okay, just checking you knew them. They are up in the mountain, probably making weapons right now. This is just where we sell some stuff. Can I interest you in anything?
Oh, not to worry. I was just looking for them. I'll pop up to the forge. I know where it is. I just wanted to make sure where they were. Thank you very much for your help.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll just go and I'll be like, right, we've got a bit of a hike on our hands.
Mm-hmm. And you do spend, again, the next couple hours just climbing a mountain, pretty much.
I'll talk to Marion on the way up and I'll be like, mm-hmm. Yeah, you know, I'm not convinced about this pirate thing.
I don't want to rule out any leads. I'm just a bit unsure why this specific lead needs so much attention.
It's this group, you see. Once they get their mind set on something, they don't look at other things. They just
yes.
Do it.
That does tend to be the way with adventuring companies. I once worked with a company who was so convinced that this necklace was of import, but it turned out to just literally be a necklace.
That's interesting. Yeah.
Yeah, a bit of a waste of time, really.
Hmm.
But I'm like I say, I'm used to working with adventuring companies like yourselves. I'm used to these kind of wacky shenanigans that you all seem to be getting up to. And
I don't want to point out my shenanigans are not wacky.
He says, "Yes, your shenanigans are very serious."
Yes,
I am
a very serious person. No sense of humor at all. You know, I didn't just become king within a week. Definitely didn't happen. None of that. No.
She'll just give you like a smirk. Say, I do enjoy this sort of life, but for a while now, my visions have been shrouded in darkness, and I have been preparing for this coming shadow for a while now, and it almost seems like my entire life has been building to it. Let's see that we don't fail.
I'll just kind of like roll my shoulders a bit, and I'll be kind of like, oh, well, you and me both.
Yes, I can see there was at least some purpose in bringing you back to life, but who knows if there's more to it yet.
Well, you know, interesting.
Maybe I should have
interestingly enough, I have actually communed, I think, about 3 or 4 times now with Torm directly, which was... Yeah, well, that was...
What did he say to you?
Well, the first time was when he, shortly after you resurrected me, you see, and he gave me my powers. Because I wandered for a bit, didn't really know what to do with myself, because, you know, everyone was dead.
And yes.
It's just me, really. So I wandered, and then he came to me, and I took the vow and got my powers from him. The second time, he gave me a vision for recovering the Holy Avenger in the Abyss, of all places.
Ah, yes, you need to go and fetch yourself one of these. She'll pull out the rod and just, like, wave it in front of your face and say, like, I've got one, you don't.
Yeah, I get it. Well, at least you're, you know, the Abyss, and he gave me that.
Yes.
And then, in fact, when I was in Neverwinter, one of the first couple of days when I was there, having discovered everything, I was in the chapel in the Hall of Justice, and I prayed, and he answered, and told me to do what I thought was best.
I suppose that's all any of the gods really want from us, is just for us to do our best.
Yeah, indeed. I mean, and I think I did.
But I think you did as well.
I think only time will tell, but we'll see. Oh, but yes, this business with Hundar, once he's gone, then it'll be into the Abyss.
Yes, into the planes of existence. Which I will, I'll join you for if you need me, if you wish.
Oh, please. A cleric will always be helpful.
Yes.
And you know, who knows, after this is all done, I still owe you a life debt, so if you need a place, Neverwinter's open to you.
I'll consider it. Personally, I quite like the aesthetic of Silvery Moon. Neverwinter, no offense, it's a bit run down.
Yeah, I'm working on that.
I'm sure you will be. We'll say it's at this point you sort of come around the bend of the climb, and you see about halfway up the mountain a big stone door that leads within.
Yes, these two are quite interesting. They have no loyalty towards Hundar at all, and they're very much just in for their business. So we can probably get a little bit more information about maybe people we can talk to about magic in the city, considering they're well-renowned dwarves. I also kind of want to have a look at some of their special offers.
Well, head on in. And you open up the doors and enter into this like massive open, like hollowed out section of the mountain where there are these giant like dwarven forges. You also see just like racks and racks of dark steel weapons and armor.
Oh, yep.
heading on in, we'll say it's easy enough for you to find the two brothers, Darbos and Dargan. They say, "Hey, it was you from the other day."
Yes, hello.
Hello. Come to use some of that gold you've got on some of our fine items?
Oh, I wanted to, yes, twofold, really. I wanted to come and have a look at what you're doing and see what you've got on offer, and also just a couple of questions about some of the locals as well. That's all right.
Sure. Well, go ahead and ask your questions while I lead you to the expensive stuff.
Oh, yes. How expensive are we talking at the moment? Like, what's your bottom line?
Most of the good stuff you're going to be paying for will be about 5,000 gold.
Ooh, okay. I'll check my purse at the minute and be like, I'll look at Marion, how much have you got?
Yeah, coin purse.
I just imagine Tristan walking around with like a handbag.
Jeez, you guys need to get immersed in this scenario.
You've all got purses.
No, I don't have a purse.
It's alright, I'm all.
You do, wallets don't exist.
Oh, Patrick, I was going to say, is there a bank in the city?
You don't know.
Oh, okay. I'll ask him. I'll be like, is there a bank in the city?
Probably, but I wouldn't trust your money with it.
Oh, great. Damn it.
Wait, how much gold have you got? Not 5,000?
No, I've only got 1,000 on me. I've got 6,000 in my bank, but that's in the bank, which is why I was asking, because, you know, transfers and all that, notes and stuff.
Yes, well, unfortunately, I don't think you're going to be able to access that. But we'll show you the gear, and you can always come back another day if you do wish to purchase it.
Yeah, well...
Go ahead and ask your question.
Yes, so we were curious about, like, anyone within the city who you would consider, or, you know, particularly studious of magic. Like, any tradesmen or sort of scholars that you would come across in your paths?
Not that I know of, particularly. I'm sure some of the assassins on this island have got magical abilities. Why do you ask what kind of things you need exactly?
We came across some strange magic that we've not really seen before. The ability to come back from the dead, but not, as you could imagine, either celestial, like, you know, if I was to bring someone back from the dead, or like a necromancer would. They just died. They did die, and then their wounds healed, and straight as normal came back to life. Same personality, same everything. So, you know, we're just curious.
As enchanters and purveyors of magical items ourselves, well, we certainly don't have that kind of skill. There are probably very powerful items out there that could maybe be the cause of it.
Yes, I was just trying to think of, any possible sort of item that would cause that, because...
It would have to be a very unique artifact, one of in immense power, but I'm sure things like that exist in this crazy world we live in.
Yeah, probably, yeah. Okay. So a rare artifact, maybe one of its kind.
Perhaps, aye. Certainly, I've never heard of an item that could do such a thing. So it's probably very rare.
Yeah.
Any other questions?
I'll kind of look at Marion and kind of go, well, what do you think?
Just say, what's your opinion of the tyrant here? Well, she's done right by Mintarn, as far as I can tell. She's easy enough to trade with and do business with. She seems fine. Here we are, and they will lead you over to the special magic item section. And if you go to handouts, you see Ironstar Dwarves wares.
Damn, that's some good stuff.
Any critical hit becomes a normal hit.
Damn. And that gives me +2 to AC, Paddy.
Yep.
So that's the same as my plate, right?
Your plate gave you +1.
My plate gave me +1. Oh, damn. Ooh, that dark steel plate would be nice. I kind of like, Tristan will like admire the armor.
Yeah, you can see it's nice stuff. Again, it doesn't quite fit with your like paladin aesthetic, as it is like black, sort of like dark, you know, dark steel. But yeah, it's good shit that they sell here.
I just kind of look to the dwarf and be like, so I know it's dark steel, but I assume you could maybe work some like darker colors into it. Do you know what I mean?
You want it to be darker?
No, like a dark blue or something on like one side.
Well, this is sort of how the metal comes, really.
Ah, okay. So you can't really, like, work a binding agent in or anything like that, no?
No, you could find some kind of enchanting stone or illusory stone that would have it appear differently, but that's not in our
that's
toolbox.
Fine. I was just curious, that's all, you know? I mean, it doesn't fit with the paladin armor, but I am a bit conspicuous, aren't I?
If you're going to be wearing armor, you're going to be conspicuous anyway. You might as well have the best stuff, and you'll tap his one of his shields.
Oh yeah, no, this is definitely some good stuff. Yeah, damn.
Expenny though.
It is. However, I would 100% empty my bank account for a
player. Merrim will say, "I have a little over 1,000 gold on me. If that's of any use to you."
Well, if we want plate armor, then I'd need an extra 3,000.
Ah, awesome.
No, but I appreciate the offer though. Thank you.
Merrim will say, "I mean, maybe we should not right now. Maybe after the dragon's dead. But we could always teleport back here."
That's true, we could, yeah. And I'm probably going to be needing to give this armor back to the Order of the Golden Lion, seeing as I have officially resigned from it.
While Tristan is perusing wares, I will cut back to the rest of the gang, who, as you come upon this this cove, it's essentially just a crack in the face of the cliff, and you are led down into rowing boats and spend the next sort of 10 minutes just rowing your way through into this hidden cove.
The music with it as well.
Great timing. Anything else you guys want to have done before you arrived or while you are going in?
I think so.
Do we want to not modify his memory again to like at least specify how he knows us?
No, I think we're good. Let's not cause more suspicion. Because yeah. Remember, it's only
more suspicion by not addressing this. It's alright for you. You can fucking run.
He's already told his crew that we came into his room. So then, if we modify his memory to be different than his crew,
not modify that. Just sort of give a more robust backstory as to how he knows us and what our like.
I don't think you can create because an event with
his entire crew. His entire crew saw our meeting.
There's no way to invent a meeting.
So I don't think we can do anything.
Yeah. It's not great, but it's the best we've got.
You would literally have to modify the memory of like all 30 odd crew members.
We ain't got time for that.
Yeah, we're gonna go out on a limb here. Days. And so you don't you spend
It's only the past 3-4 hours as well, so we wouldn't even be able to do that.
Oh yeah, you physically wouldn't be able to, yeah.
I could at higher levels 30 days ago. 7th level. 8th level.
Everyone will have starved to death by the time you're done.
The dragon would have been back. Well, like, and
yeah, everyone's already dead.
Yeah, true. And the Shadow King's already back.
At least we're on an island, so we're safe.
Sure. This is right next to where the dragon lives.
Yeah, dragons can't go across water though, so.
Yeah, the dragon's pretty mad
they
at
can't swim.
As well.
Yeah, dragons can't swim, so how are they going to get here? If you guys then will sail on through into this cove. Like I say, after about 10 minutes of rowing, you come upon a portcullis section, which is raised, as you know, people recognize some faces. And you are led on into a like small sort of docks area. Here you see a number of like blue-skinned humanoids. I'll say if anyone wants to make a nature check or a history check, sorry, nature or religion, I would say go for it.
Anyone know anything about those?
I'm a 3 at nature.
Oh wow, look, Daylar with the religion.
Damn. Makes sense.
Actually.
makes sense for Daylar as well, seeing as he did know about unbelief before. I'll say Daylar, as you recognize these, as you see these blue-skinned people, it looks like they were once like regular human beings, but something's been done to them. And you gather it is something to do with Umberly and the blessing or curse, as some might call it, of the sea goddess that sort of like just drained the blood from their bodies, or at least made it so they
what
just
a blessing.
Yeah, it doesn't look very comfortable at all. They almost look like corpses, but obviously they are up and moving.
Interesting.
And they have like some sort of sea-like things about them.
So sorry, they worship the sea, right?
They worship Umberly, who is one of the goddesses of the sea.
So they're not, although they worship a god, they're not. Do they still care about money as they're pirates, or what is their main goal for?
Well, I mean, different people, different people have different goals. You would gather that, like, it probably does do to pay homage. If you're going to be a pirate and you're going to be on the sea, you might as well pray to a sea god so that you get, like, decent waves and stuff like that. And
I mean, they weren't all blue people, like the captain isn't, and all they obviously must still care a lot about gold.
Yeah, you gather, yeah, for some of them it's probably more like a, we'll worship this goddess so that we can do pirating, but then some of them are probably the other way around, where it's like, we worship the goddess and then we just do pirating on the side.
Because they worship the sea and water and whatnot, do they hate, like, elements opposing that, like fire and dragons?
Not necessarily.
Do they worship the Kraken?
Well, you don't know.
Okay.
It's that information, Dale.
You're welcome, guys.
But yeah, sailing into this little cove, I will say make perception checks, all of you.
Alright.
I thought I rolled the 18 for a second. I was like, yeah. Oh, finally a good perception.
Reed and Dela, you have like just a little look overboard, and yeah, you see four sharks just circling the water beneath.
Oh no. We're not going to walk the plank, are we?
Can we ask the captain about them?
Sure, what do you say?
What's up with these sharks under the water?
Do you expect them to be over the water?
They just seem to be following us.
Aye, the Weave Mistress has many servants, including those of the sea.
Aww,
impressive.
Yeah, you are led up into this cove. A few figures stand out, other than just these regular people.
I have a bad feeling about this.
One of them looks like a merfolk, but they are like 10 feet tall, which is odd. You've never seen one this big. The other looks like
yesterday, so
yeah. And then you do see a woman in sort of like not even robes, just like a military attire almost. Like short brown hair. Very, very stern glance, and Shiva will get out of the boat and say, "Ah, Wave Mistress," and he will bow before her. She will immediately say, "Who are these three? Why have you brought them here?" Yeah, you can bow as well.
Yeah, I will as well.
Yeah, Shiva will say, "They're good friends of mine. They came seeking an audience with you." He will then just like bow and step back, allowing you guys to step forward if you wish.
Are we all stepping forward or just me?
I guess we all will.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But like slightly behind you because you're going to be doing most of the talk.
Okay.
Say, who are you and why is it so important that I speak with you? What can you offer me? I sense something about you.
Really?
Yes.
All good, I hope.
I sense power. Power yes. can be useful.
You are correct. We are
Have
very
you
powerful.
Spent much time on the sea yourselves?
Not recently as... apart from traveling to Mintarn, but not as frequent as your fellows. We have a proposition for you. I'll speak frank. We are mercenaries of the highest quality, and we seek fortune, and we believe our fortune is on this, I forgot what the island's called.
Skadarak.
Our fortune is on Skadarak.
Your treasure hunters.
Yes. What, would you have any, would you be able to provide us with any assistance or information on the island?
Well,
and there will be something in it for you.
Yes, first of all, I was about to say, what is in it?
Share of the treasure.
How much?
One eighth.
Eighth of the share. First of all, go ahead and scroll just a deception check just for how far we're going so far. Cool. Let me actually roll insight.
Is it actually deception, though?
Well, yeah. You're... Yeah,
no, it is.
We're not really being honest, right. So...
I'm not giving them anything. I'm not planning to, and I thought we agreed that. I mean...
Yeah, that
means... Yeah, just wondering.
It's wisdom, right? Is insight? I think it is.
Oh, that was close.
That would have been it for us. Polymorph into rat and run.
Into a rat.
You can dimension door.
Hey, you can dimension door, actually. That's a great point.
And we take a ship.
I did, but like where? Like out of the cove?
Into a ship, yeah. Because don't forget, we had to come into the boat.
I feel like trying to get a rat right in front of them.
Run away.
Run into the water and just get nommed by a shark.
Yep. But yeah, so carry on. Things are going well so far. She doesn't seem to have clocked on yet.
Any information and assistance you could provide would be welcomed.
My first question to you would be, many thieves have tried to steal from Hundar in the past. All have failed. From what I gather, it amuses him to watch them fail. What makes you think you can succeed where they have not?
Well, we are... I am a skilled burglar. I've stolen many things on the... wherever we normally reside. like the whole...
Do you actually
area.
Say
What's
that?
It called? Like Middle Earth or some
shit? Oh, the Sword Coast.
Yeah, just the Sword Coast.
Sword Coast. Yeah. I've stolen many things on the Sword Coast. And can I just be like, I've even, I've stolen from a dragon before. And then I'm just going to throw a dragon tooth to prove it.
Okay.
So, yeah.
Go ahead and roll Persuasion with advantage.
And I'll be saying I'll be wanting that back.
She'll just gesture for one of her. In fact, she has a bodyguard that's been with her like the whole time. He will just pick it up and chuck it back to you.
Nice.
And so you've killed dragons before, but Hundar is no mere dragon.
Yes. Well, we need information and we need resource, and you can provide that. But he is currently not here right now. So speed is the key. Our sources tell us anyway. However, he is returning in the next 2 days. I can roll deception if you want.
I mean, you don't know necessarily. So it wouldn't necessarily be deception. Because
he's trying to deceive himself.
I'm just telling it 2 days so that she feels like she's got time to help us with whatever we want to do.
I'll say sure. Go ahead and roll another deception, and I will make another insight check.
Nice.
Is
that the wrong character?
What? Oh shit!
Yeah, he's like.
I
telling the truth.
You know, Shiva from behind goes. I think they're telling the truth, boss.
I'm not making funny. Mate.
My friends would lie to me.
It's on sign.
Yes, let me roll an actual one. The way just there we go.
Ooh.
Still high, but not 27.
It wasn't actually possible for it to get that unless you got like a nat 20 and then.
Yes, but I would say a nat 20 is a nat 20. Yeah, so it's still worth rolling. So she will say, and the dragon, I imagine he has quite a large hoard. How do you expect to extract all of that in 2 days?
We need 1 hour, and we're not
just
even 1 hour.
Point to Daylight's bag of holdings.
We've got multiple bag of holdings that we can store all the treasure in easily.
You see her eyes go to Daylight's in particular, and just linger on that for a moment.
Okay. Hmm.
Go ahead and roll one more persuasion check for me. There is a way that I know of, a certainly less guarded way than the front door. From what I understand, it is an entrance Hundar is aware of, but it is not one he can easily guard, for its entrance lies beneath the sea.
Really?
Yes. If I have your word that you will give me an eighth of the treasure, I could show you where that entrance might be.
Okay. Well, that's... I kind of look at the others and just see their response.
Kind of nod.
Yeah.
I'll also nod.
I'll say agreed. But I'd also like to ask, could she, if we message... if we were to message for assistance, could they attack main entrance with their cannons, just as a distraction, if we were desperate?
She will say, we will not be getting involved in any way. This is the only reason I'm helping you is because the dragon would have no knowledge of my involvement. If I was to send a ship, that would implicate the Black Skulls, and that I cannot do.
Very well.
But if, yeah, with this entrance, you won't need a distraction.
Yep, agreed. And can we shake on it?
Sure. As you shake on it, she does pull you in, like very much like pinning you with her hand, and say, tell me, are you a follower of the goddess Umberly? Or of any god?
I am a follower of every god and none at the same time.
This displeases her. You can tell. Just pledge yourself to Umberly. Without her blessing, you will struggle to get through the door.
What would this entail? What would I need to do? What would be bad? Can I look at daylight being raw religion? What does this mean?
It would require an offering or a sacrifice, some way of proving yourself to her.
It really depends.
How about you show us this entrance first, and then we can decide if we about
if
that.
You deliver. Yeah, I'm not agreeing to anything before we actually you deliver on your side of the bargain. Yeah, the agreement is you get 1/8 of the treasure for the hidden entrance and assistance. Everything else will cost extra.
My dear, the entrance itself is bound to the sea. Anything to do with the sea requires the goddess's permission. It is not in my power to simply grant you access. It is only in hers.
Well, can't we have a guide? This big, tall, lanky fella could guide us, right? You know, the mer guy.
Yeah, he will walk over and say, I can guide you, but... And he'll just, like, look to the Wavemistress, and she will again say, yes, the door still requires a payment of some kind to the goddess herself.
Show us this door first so we can verify.
If a sacrifice or a gift, a specific gift, isn't good enough, gold will always suffice for the gods.
How much?
Well, it depends.
Well, this god sounds corrupt as fuck. I'm sorry, I have to pay him.
It's her, and yes, the gods are corrupt. Of course they are.
Oh my lord. Well, we'll get to the entrance, and this Murguy or yourself can advise on what sacrifice needs to be made. It really depends on what sacrifice we're talking here. I don't want to lose any limbs.
Yes, yeah, so let's be shown the entrance first, and then we
go ahead and
work
roll
our
me
own way.
Persuasion sank.
Oh, not me again.
Oh no.
You're good at this one.
Oh, that's 20!
She will say, wait here a moment. And she will head, like, further in the cave. You look across at Shiver, who just gives you a thumbs up as if to say, like, it's going well.
Oh, yeah, my mates are so cool.
Yeah. After a few minutes, she will come back with a map. And she will mark on the map and say, this is the precise location of the entrance to Skadarak. And it's just like a point in the ocean, about halfway between Mintarn and Skadarak. There you will find the ruins of an abandoned temple to Umberley. Like I say, the entrance itself is sealed magically, and from what I gather, requires a sacrifice of some kind to the goddess.
What kind of sacrifices does she like?
Anyone will do, really.
Anyone?
Anyone?
Yes, as long as long, well, yes, of course. As long as they're not, members of her following herself or any of the other deities of fury.
Does it have to be a person, or can it be like a beast? Or
it'd have to be a lot of beasts, hundreds, if not thousands. People are much easier. You'd have to do the sacrifice down there underwater as well, which getting a herd of animals beneath there would be a task. If you know anybody, anyone holy, anyone who would be in opposition to yes, anyone who would naturally oppose Umberley would be a great sacrifice.
I think I know the person for the job.
I have a cunning plan.
Say goodbye, Tristan.
Yeah. She will roll up the map and hand it to you and say, well, the choice is yours now. If you fail, we were never involved.
Of course.
If you succeed, we expect our payment, and the Black Skulls will get their payment.
One last thing. Where would be a good place to get a ship?
Well, a ship would be hopeless in this endeavor.
Surely shippers could give us a lift.
Well, we need a way to get to the island, you know.
We could sail you past and drop you off on the way, but the ship would have to sail and then keep moving if it stayed there for too long. We could drop you near the appropriate position.
Okay, we can contact our friend and Captain Shivers if we need that.
Do you have any more information of what lies within the area, Wavemistress?
I am afraid not. All I know is rumors and hearsay. The same thing you've probably already heard yourselves, that Hundar enjoys watching people try and steal from his lair, because they always fail and they always die. And yes, that's all I know, is that it's trapped.
But do you know anyone that survived his lair, or would know any more information on Mintarn?
I doubt anyone has survived, except perhaps the most powerful of wizards, but I know nothing of them.
Very well. Well, thank you, and I think we'll be on our way, and I'll look to the others.
Or not.
I guess we'll bow, and I guess I'll bow and leave.
Yeah, we'll do the same.
Yep. Shiva will lead you out and say, well, I think that went that went well.
Yeah.
I don't know why you couldn't just have told me to begin with that the dragon was your quarry, but fair enough.
I'm sorry.
People around here tend to be very kind of wary about talking about the dragon, so...
We knew you would know eventually, but we didn't want to mention it on Mintarn for as risk it would become public knowledge. We wanted to have everybody in the room that needs to know.
Sure.
We did tell you just at the right time.
Very well. You row back onto the ship and begin sailing back to port, I guess.
Can I use detect magic on the map that she gave us?
Yes, you can. It is not magical.
Okay, I was like looking for like a if she left like a mark on it or something, like to track us.
No, it doesn't seem to be magical or have any sort of mark. Yeah, and you would know that. Yeah, seems
to be. Can I send a sending spell to Tristan?
Tristan will say at this time you're just perusing the dwarven wares.
Oh yeah, cool. Sounds good.
Oh, I wish I had money.
They made agreement with Wave Mistress. 1/8 of treasure for hidden entrance. Sacrifice required. Ellipsis. Find information. I think that's all the words I've got. If I've got three more, I'd say three more words. meet at port. Yeah. Dock. Fuck.
I think he would know what that.
Okay. I guess I get this.
You get 15 words back.
I go
25.
You're a dick.
I go. So, you made an agreement, which is awful. But we'll meet you at the dock.
Anything else?
That's it.
I'll be like, guys, I think Tristan's not happy.
It's okay, I'm going to sacrifice him.
Yeah, he won't be around much longer.
Yeah. Seriously, though, what the fuck do we do? I don't want to sacrifice myself or anyone else.
No.
Can't we just...
Yeah, I don't trust this, like...
At all.
It sounds also, like a bad idea, yeah.
She was, like, looking at my bag of holding. I don't know if she, like, made a connection, like, with the people who attacked film, like, near Draconia.
What about that? Hmm. What happened there?
You know, because we, like, attacked their base, like,
yeah,
and then stole their ship.
Yeah. What would the bag of holding have to do with that?
I don't know, like, maybe the bag of holding is, like, really rare, and, like, a drow with a bag of holding might be suspicious.
Did you get it there?
I got it before there, but, like, yeah. if they saw a drow there... With...
If you want to make an insight check, Daylar, go for it. It'll be quite a high DC. Nah, not enough, unfortunately.
Can I do one?
No, this would just be a Daylar thing.
Yeah, I just don't know what sacrifice... I mean, what a Kraken do?
I don't think so, because she's a sea goddess. If we're sacrificing a sea animal, she'd be like, why have you killed my pet?
Well, actually, Daylar on a religion check would know. I mean, Kraken might be her pet, but it also might not be. It's not like necessarily.
Yeah. Either way, that would involve killing a Kraken, which we certainly don't have time for.
Yeah.
Yes.
Kraken and a dragon in one day.
We've only got a word for it that this door requires a sacrifice. We don't know that.
Yeah, but let's contingency plan. Like, what kind of sacrifice can we make?
Is there, like, some other person we can bring that we don't care about?
We don't really want to be getting involved in that, do we?
Well...
Maybe there's, like, criminals on death row or something.
She did say a sacrifice or a gift of some kind, or just money, you know? Like, it doesn't have to be a sacrifice.
Do we have a gift? What gift could we... They like a dragon tooth. I keep using that.
Mints?
We could... Mints? Oh, the mints.
yes. The magic mints.
Everyone likes mints.
It might be like Mentos, though, and it, like, fizzes the ocean. And,
like, would you like a cannon?
No, don't give her a cannon. We need all the cannons we can get.
I mean, how much gold would she need? I've got 1,000 gold. Maybe we could just pool all our gold together.
I don't know.
Let's get her some fucking grey dwarven armour. Whatever it's called.
Yeah, we're gonna rob all the armor from that shop. That'd be a good gift.
We could ask the tyrant if there's a death row prisoner or something, and, like, we could just take them and sacrifice
killing
them.
Killing people, man. It's sacrifice. Like, it's bad.
But if they're gonna die anyway.
Yeah, but exactly. Yeah, neutral, like, though, right? No, if they're like some evil prisoner, then
even I think that's evil, on the evil side.
But.
Even if they're bad.
We're using it so we can kill the dragon, though. So in a way, they'd actually be dying. Their dying would be much more purposeful.
Yeah. Morals aside, like, the religious, the torn bunch, they're not going to like that.
Yeah, that's true.
I think they're better off giving some sort of gift.
Maybe we don't
mention...
Do we have
anything in the bag of holding?
Let's not mention the human sacrifice.
We have to take them underwater, though, and slit their throats by the gate or some shit.
Yeah, so we could do that, and then we could tell
just
paladins
and
later.
And we'll be like, who's that guy you're bringing with you? All tied up. Oh, never mind. Don't you worry.
You modify their memories. They'll be like, oh, he's our friend. Yeah.
Yeah, he's just that mate. We were bringing him with us. He's just like all terrified, all like bound and shit. Like, sweating.
I will change your alignment.
We've got a knife like pointed at his back, like, you don't fucking say a thing.
Modify his memory as well.
Yeah. You're our friend, we're gonna murder you.
Yeah, this is sounding pretty chaotic evil, not gonna lie.
Yeah. Is at the very least sounding chaotic neutral.
We must have something in the bag of holding that we could give.
Like, I don't know.
What about the Staff of Thunder and Lightning that I picked up? No one needs that.
Yeah, what about that and a bunch of gold?
I think just the staff, because you can stick that in the sand.
Dela, on his 27 relationship, would know that, like, the staff itself, because it is like a thunder and lightning staff specifically, would probably be a start.
A start.
I mean, I feel like if she wants, like, the sacrifice of someone holy, then...
Holy, just someone who, like, actively opposes evil. So, you know, generally speaking, the holy people.
So she wants like a kind of a big sacrifice. So like, I don't think one gift is gonna cut it.
Well, we'll say. Wait, do you guys want to keep talking on your own, or do you want to wait till we regroup with the others?
We'll get back. I think the staff and a bit of gold should do the trick.
Let's just not mention the human sacrifice.
Okay.
I mean, I've already. Oh no, I said sacrifice of sorts.
Yeah, I think you did already mention sacrifice.
Yeah, just don't mention that part.
I mean,
I'm already not, mentioned.
It's already been mentioned, I'm not an idiot.
But Tristan, why are you talking about sacrifice?
Yeah, well,
nah, you can't gaslight me.
When we say sacrifice, we can just mean like the gold.
No one says when they say sacrifice to an evil sea goddess, no one means give him a coin.
Yeah.
Well, we'll say you guys all meet up, all six of you. Rogar is now there as well. We'll say, all right, guys, I've scouted the island. It looks pretty fucking impenetrable. Is that the word?
Give me 20 good men.
So like, there's like three different like walls and battlements surrounding this one entrance. The docks, like the harbor area looked pretty empty. I guess they sent most of their ships away already. But yeah. We're not getting in the front door, basically. Unless we all went invisible, but then, like, they might have wards and shit, I don't know.
They probably do, yeah.
What did you guys find?
Yes, what did you guys find? Something about an evil sea goddess, sacrifices, yada yada yada.
Well, we have a lot of items that we don't use, and we're not gonna use, so we can...
Either human sacrifice, either...
Yeah, well, that's not happening.
Some sign. Yeah, I know. Either a gift of some sign,
it's definitely not
type, or money. So I'm thinking we've got this Staff of Thunder and Lightning that no one's using. That kind of goes well with the sea and that god. Why don't that with like a bit of plunder?
Just the idea of sacrificing anything to this goddess does not sit well with me.
Did you find out anything else?
Any involvement did you find another way in then?
You don't have to have any... involvement in this. You can just not approve of it. Then... Let us do it.
I mean,
we can have all the treasure.
Marion, as a follower of the gods, will step forward and say, it doesn't sit well with me either, but does seem like it needs to be done. We can deal with the consequences of this sacrifice or gift later. I don't think much will come of it. People sacrifice things to evil gods all the time, and it doesn't end the world. Whereas what we're facing will end the world.
Yeah, well, it's at the end of the day, it's to kill the dragon.
Yeah, and what could a sea goddess do with a few thousand gold anyway?
All right, what have you found? How else can we get in?
All I know is that what we're looking for, that brought him back from the dead, will be pretty obvious. Like, we're talking...
some big powerful
rare artifact, yeah.
Yeah, well, we kind of knew that already.
That's all I know. But
So we're the only ones that have found anything useful.
And Rogar.
Oh yeah, and Rogar.
Thanks, Dumla. Marion will say, I think we've wasted enough time. This dragon could be back any minute. We need to We need to get moving.
Yeah, we
I agree.
And our friend also offered to drop us off outside.
Yeah, so we've got a lift.
Yeah.
And a cannon ship.
Oh, pirates.
We'll need some water breathing potions, I imagine.
Yeah, probably.
Yes.
Yes, absolutely.
So we need to stock up on water breathing potions and then head out.
Oh, and she also did say that Hundar knows about this entrance, but it's not as actively guarded.
Yeah, I mean, if it requires a massive sacrifice to even open it, then like chances are it's not going to be that.
And it's underwater.
But it could still have like.
But yeah,
we're not like sneaking in.
We imagine
like,
every
unknown
entrance
place
will be some kind of. Yeah. It's the best bet we've
yeah.
got.
Yeah,
I think
saying that
yes.
not going
yeah.
in like
yeah.
sneakily.
We
well,
might,
we are, but like
we might all want to buy fire resistance potions.
You know, we can just.
I've already got.
Yeah, I already
yeah,
got them.
I've got a tattoo, mate.
Marion is not. She will purchase some.
How much is a water breathing potion?
Tristan will buy a fire resistance potion and a water breathing potion.
Yep. The fire resistance potions will be 200 each. And what else was it I was looking for?
Water breathing.
Water breathing.
Let's see what rogue.
150 each for those.
150.
I'll buy.
I
want to
buy
four.
Three.
Yeah, because you don't know how deep it is, how long you'll be down there.
Actually,
I think
I'll buy four as well.
However much Marion can afford, she's going to buy quite a lot.
What's 4 times 150, Sean?
600.
Holy shit, why does Rogar have 14,000 gold?
Oh, Tristan, do you want me to buy you that armor?
Yeah, you know, Rogar, there's this really good armor I was looking at. I could use the upgrade, you know.
Oh, yeah, but like, it's my money, though.
Oh,
so.
Yeah, but you know, we're like best mates.
You're the same.
Can you pay me back?
Rogar,
oh,
we might
I mean,
need
like,
your money to pay the.
Well, you see, the
fine
thing is, Rogar, I need to get. I've got 6,000 cash in the Waterdeep bank, so you lend me the 5k for it. I'll pay you back when we get to Waterdeep.
Can I get like 5,010 back?
I mean, what you want
interest?
You want interest?
Yeah, like 10 gold.
Yeah, sure, mate. So Tristan's bought his potions. Rogar will also buy, I guess.
Technically, at the end of the day, only 3 of you were up and awake to do a hero's feast.
Oh,
I'd
true.
Say
yeah, I wasn't.
Probably worth doing a full one, like another one anyway.
Cool, I'll do it again.
Oh yeah, and Paddy, can I go get that plate armor? Yeah, sound.
Sure, I mean...
We got time to waste on that?
I was gonna say...
We need to get going on the ship.
Yeah.
Oh, damn.
Rogar will be like, oh, I'll lend you like when we get back from all this.
Yeah. Oh, you might not need to lend me it then, but yeah, it's alright. Thanks, bud. I appreciate it.
Okay. Well, so you spend an hour heroes feasting for that extra seven hit points. So make sure you add those on. Well.
How much did you say the water breathing and fire potions were again? 200 and 150, right?
Yeah. So Marion's going to buy 4 underwater potions and...
I bought 4 as well.
And 2 fire resistance potions.
All right. Tristan will buy 2 fire res and 3 water.
Marion's down to 200 gold.
Tristan will be
down. Alright, I'm down to 417.
Tristan's got 450. Then Rogar... Well,
what did you spend all your money on?
Tristan?
Sang.
She just spams potions, doesn't she?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Speed, flying, convincing.
Yes, I was going to say, you spent like 3,000 gold on like prepping for the last dragon
health
fight.
Potions.
Yeah.
I've got 7 superior health potions.
bearing in mind, people will need to save up some gold for this potential sacrifice of gold.
Oh, I'm not getting involved in that.
Do we not have enough, like, items?
Oh, maybe.
We'll have to see when we get there. Rogar can make up the difference with his 10,000 gold.
Maybe. We'll see. As long as Tristan pays me back.
Do you have a list, Daylight? Do you have a list of like things we've kept in the bag of holding?
No, but I'm just looking at like the items list that in the journal.
Yeah, we'll have to do a full like scan of that and figure out what we can.
Yeah.
Dish out.
So as the afternoon goes on, you sail to this specific point, and yeah, I guess everyone then chugs potions and just sort of hops out on the way.
Yep.
Yeah.
Daylight, make a perception check.
Can I make a joke to Tristan?
Go on then.
Oh, okay.
Can I say, Tristan, for the sacrifice, think we're going to have to give the crown of Neverwinter.
Absolutely. Well, you know, the thing is, Reed, I don't have it on me, so good luck with that.
Oh, yeah, good point.
Rogar!
I'll teleport right away.
Yeah. To be fair, we could actually just get Rogar to, like, rob us a load of shit in Waterdeep and, like, bring it back. Nah, never mind.
That'll waste more spells, though.
Yeah.
So yeah, you didn't spot anything on a 60, unfortunately, Dayla. So yeah, you guys head on beneath the waves. I will say you spend about an hour just swimming down. So that burns through one potion. You then chug your second one, and around just after you've chugged your second one, you do come across what looks to be some kind of underwater temple.
Nice.
That'll be the place. Can we swim there stealthily while checking for traps?
Swimming stealthily, I'm going to say, but...
I mean, we're underwater, it doesn't make a difference.
Yeah, it's tough to swim stealthily, but...
We're in water, right? So can I technically walk on water while in water?
No.
Absolutely not.
What?
It's like some sort of mime.
That's like saying, well, I'm breathing air, so can I run on air?
Can I cast Pass Without a Trace?
You can. Again, I'll say for the purposes of this, you don't really need it right now.
Okay, never mind then.
I'll say if anyone wants to make a perception check to, like, search the area to see if there is any nasty sea creatures about.
Dayla?
25. You see a few sort of groups of sharks, but, like, not, like, nearby per se, but there's creatures around.
I need to put my AC back up because I put my plate back on.
Oh yeah, same for Marion.
Wonder if these sharks are actually the ones that we saw when we went to see that woman.
Very good point.
I'll say they're far away enough at this point that they're not a threat at the moment.
I mean, to be fair, sharks don't tend to attack you unless they're hungry or you're bleeding. Then. So
that can be arranged, Tristan.
Checking out this temple, though, if anyone wants to make an investigation check.
Dayla.
Dayla.
I don't want to, but I'm being made to.
I just imagine everyone, like, forcing your head to look in certain directions.
Is there a trap there?
24. You speak primordial, right, Dayla?
Yes.
So you one of them. Primordial is just like, yeah, all of them. You do read a bunch of stuff in Primordial. On this, you see there's like a circle, circular door, sort of partway up like a cliff face beneath the ocean. Basically, it does just say in Primordial, like, a sacrifice is required in order to enter. And you do see there's like a small stone table just in front of the door with like a circular indent within the center of it.
Looks like the place.
So you gather that you're supposed to put whatever you're sacrificing on this table in order to gain entrance.
I think the crossbows are the blessed scout need to go.
And I think the demon slayer sword.
Ah, you definitely don't want that to go.
Merrim will say, "All right, can we stop quarrelling and get into this door, please?"
What's that? What's ring of free action, ring of protection? Who's got that?
I've got the ring of protection.
What's the ring of
free ring action? Ring of free action, I don't think anyone has, so we can get rid of that.
Yeah, put that down. Wand of thunder and lightning.
Wand of lightning bolts.
I think I've got that, but yeah, I can throw that in.
Mm-hmm.
That's one thing from me.
Wand of magic missile.
Oh no, sorry, I've got the wand of secrets.
Yeah, we can give the wand of magic missiles as well then. We don't need that.
Yes, just...
I don't really have anything.
On my, like, religion check, would I know, like, how much we have to give?
I'll say make another religion. 21. Gold and items equaling about 10,000 gold should suffice.
Jesus.
Yeah.
How much is that we've given then?
You don't know.
Like, have we put all those... Did we put all those ones in? And stuff, like...
What lots of ogre power do we need them?
I think Ulfgar had those, yeah.
So all right. Not... Eyes of the Eagle, what are these? Can we get rid
they're
of them?
They're my goggles.
Yeah, they're the goggles.
We're not getting rid of them.
What about the Bat Cape? Can we get rid of that?
Yeah, if you can, you guys tell me, so what you've put on there already, what are the rarities of them?
Oh yeah, good shout.
You just read your free action is rare.
Okay.
Did we put the staff of thunder and lightning?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's rare.
Okay, that's very rare.
Okay, that's very rare.
Which one is the staff of thunder and lightning?
Yeah, wand of lightning bolts is rare.
Okay.
Wand of magic missiles is uncommon.
Mm-hmm.
Polymorph is very rare.
Are we giving the wand of polymorph?
No, wait, no, wait.
No, not
the polymorph. That's Rogar's.
We need that.
Yeah, I forgot about that. Do you have the amulet of health, Sang?
Yeah, yeah, I have that.
The ring of free action is rare.
Yeah, we've...
You know, you're probably on about 8,000 gold's worth right now.
I think, what's this Sword of Vengeance?
Oh, that's gone. That's long gone.
That's long gone, yeah. Well, it just became a plus one sword, so it'd just be uncommon. But you could have it. I guess you didn't sell it.
I don't even think I've got it still, have I?
I don't know.
Tristan said that? He doesn't have it.
It's not on my list.
We'll say it's
in the bag of holding.
Not necessarily.
We didn't get rid of anything. We've kept it.
Wait, hang on a minute. I don't have the Ring of Protection.
No, I've got one of those. That can go in.
Yeah, we don't need the Ring of Protection.
Boots of Levitation are rare.
The Ring of Protection is rare. Leave the Boots of Levitation.
But, I mean...
Oh, no, that's just an action to cast Levitation spell. Yeah, no worries. Yeah, we can get rid of that.
No, the Boots... There's the Boots of Levitation. We need those.
No,
there's winged boots and there's also boots of levitation.
Yeah, the boots of levitation are rare as well.
So you're putting the boots on?
Yeah.
Winged boots are staying.
So, just to confirm, if you can read out the five items you're putting on there again, because I think you've got enough. I just want to
Ring of reaction.
Check.
Ring of protection. Okay. Staff of thunder and lightning. Wand of lightning bolts. Wand of magic missiles. And then the boots of levitation.
Okay. As you do put those boots down, there is a slight tremor in the earth before all of the items on the table turn into like this blue magical energy and then get sucked within the table. So go ahead and knock all of those off of your inventories.
Well, I don't think they're in the inventory. Just in the journal.
I have them in my... I write down what's in my bag.
No, I didn't.
But to be fair, yours...
Most of them were just in Daylar's bag of holding.
Yeah.
I'll tell you what, then. To make it easier...
So just put the entire bag of holding.
I'm getting... No, to be fair, I had the Ring of Protection on my thing, but it's greyed out, so... Yes, I don't have it equipped.
I could have gave my dog. Do they want the dog?
It's not... We're good.
I could have murdered it.
But yeah.
What's the dog's name again?
Cromwell.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, once you do put all these items on and they are consumed by the table, the door will then open in like a four-sided like spiral opening.
Ooh.
And
nice.
Yeah, darkness lies within. And as you guys swim on in, we will leave it there for tonight. But then we will kick off next session with, the island with Skadarak.
How exciting.
Yeah, we made it.
Sheesh.
And Merion was like, oh, these pirates, they're pointless. Oh, these guys, they're wasting their time.